Hello friends, welcome to the JavaScript concept tutorial. Today we will learn about the concept hoisting in the JavaScript. Hoisting is one of the most important concept in the JavaScript. Whenever we write any program in JavaScript, you must have very clear vision of the hoisting concept. Without the hosting concept, our program may crash, may run into trouble. So it is very important to know about the hoisting in the JavaScript. The practical aspect of the hoisting you will come to know only when you do the real programmings. So here we will not go into the deep, but we will try to sum up some of the important scenario or concept related to the hoisting. So let us start. Open the scratch pad of the Firefox. So here, let us write a simple JavaScript. console.log. Let us try to access a variable that does not exist. Suppose variable x here. This variable at this point of time does not exist. We have not defined this variable yet, but we are trying to use a non-existing variable. Let us see what we get the result. Go to the console, clear first, click on run. So we did not get any result in the console. Instead we get an error. What is the error? X is not defined. So this is very right error. X is not defined. We are trying to access variable X, which does not exist. If any variable does not exist, you will get this error. X is not defined. So now try to define this variable where X is equal to 20. Now we are trying to access X, and we have also defined X where X is equal to 20. Now see what happens. Try to run it. So we are getting the result in the console undefined. X is undefined. Here we are getting the result. Why? We have given the value X is equal to 20. We have also declared the variable where X and assigned the value 20. But still we are getting the result undefined. Earlier when this was not defined, not declared, we were getting the error. X is not defined. That was correct. But this time we have defined the variable. We have assigned the value and we are getting undefined. The reason is that the hosting comes here. The console.log x gives undefined. That means variable exists. Variable exists. That means JavaScript while compiling, JavaScript comes to this point and it finds the variable. So we are trying to access x here and defining later on. So what happens here, the declaration part where X, this is hoisted. This is hoisted to this place. This is hoisted to this place. So we are getting undefined. And this part X is equal to 20, this assignment part does not get hoisted. So only the declaration part where axe is hoisted above this line. Wherever we are trying to access above this line, the declaration of the variable where x is hoisted. So variable we are getting undefined. That means variable exists undefined. Variable exists, but it is not defined. The variable does not have any value, but we have assigned the value. So reason is that the declaration of the variable is hoisted here, but not the assignment. So in the general term, hoisting means the lifting something above. So this part is lifted to this place, and it finds the x, but the assignment x is equal to 20 is not hoisted to this place. That's why you are getting undefined. So this is the concept of hoisting. So whenever we use any variable in the JavaScript, we must define it before, then we should use it. It should not be that we are using before and defining later on. This is not good practice. Of course, this declaration part is hoisted, we are getting undefined. Earlier, when the variable x does not exist, we were getting the error x is not defined. That was reference error. But when we define this variable below this line console.log x, this part where x is hoisted means this is lifted above here, and we got undefined, but this part doesn't get hoisted. So one thing to remember, that the declaration of the variable is hoisted, but the assignment does not get hoisted. So friends, this was some concept regarding the hoisting of variable in the JavaScript. This is also apply to the functions. So we will later learn about the hoisting of functions in the JavaScript. For today, that's it. Thank you very much. Go through this video many times so that you can understand the concept. If you like my video, subscribe my channel. Thanks a lot.